Blackstone presents Flight Risk by Eva Hudson. This book is read by Barrie Kreinik.
Chapter 1. The man in the Miami Dolphins cap was going to be a problem. He had been shouting on his cell at the champagne and oyster bar in the departure lounge, and he was still on his phone at the gate. He was still shouting. Alcohol and anger had reddened his face to the point of sunburn. Ingrid wondered if the staff would actually let him board. Her fellow passengers gripped finely wrapped Christmas presents too precious for the hold, duty-free bags bulging with festive tipples nestled between their feet. Ingrid clutched her only piece of luggage, a small backpack containing her phone, wallet, passport, FBI badge, and embassy ID, plus some lip balm and a copy of the motorcycle diaries she'd hastily bought in the airport bookstore. She'd been more attracted to the word motorcycle than the prospect of reading Che Guevara's life story, but she was on a search for meaning and in the mood for adventure. The book promised both. She had failed to find a gift for her mother. She guessed she'd end up going home for the holidays, but it didn't really matter, because whatever she bought her mom would either end up in a bottom drawer or the Goodwill, unless it was cigarettes or vodka. Realistically, Ingrid was not going to read on the plane. She had far too much on her mind to concentrate on a book. She had a resignation letter to draft, an explanation to come up with for her unexpected arrival in the States, and an entire future to figure out. The only thing she knew for sure was it was time to leave London. She now had 7 hours in the air to decide whether to ask for a transfer to another field office or walk away from the FBI altogether. Unless leaving London without authorization had already taken the choice out of her hands, she could well be fired before the end of the day.
"We would like to invite premium economy and passengers with children or special needs to come forward for boarding."
The man in the cap grunted. He gave the impression of someone used to flying business, and traveling with the horde insulted his status. The man was either a grade-A jerk or the one person on the flight whose life was a bigger mess than her own. Ingrid knew the rates of suicide among middle-aged men spiked around Christmas, and she sensed his rage, though currently outwardly directed, was really for himself. She'd overheard enough of his conversations to know his children were spending their first Christmas with his ex-wife and her new partner, a classic trigger for both homicidal and suicidal behavior. The gate staff called for the first rows of economy passengers to board, and almost everyone got to their feet. Ingrid had an aisle seat. She would wait till the end to get up. The people who leaped to their feet weren't going to cross the Atlantic any quicker than she was. When the final call for all remaining passengers was made, Ingrid approached the desk and offered the clerk her passport and boarding pass. The woman scanned the documents, then scanned them again. Her features puckered before she raised her gaze to Ingrid. She grabbed a roll of blue paper towels from under the counter and wiped the scanner before holding the documents over the laser again. "Is there a problem?" Ingrid asked. The woman, early 20s and heavily made up for the time of day, made Ingrid excruciatingly aware she hadn't bathed and was looking decidedly crumpled.
"I just need to get my colleague, Benita."
Benita, older, even more elegant, joined from the other desk, looked at something on the screen, then scrutinized Ingrid. She scanned the passport herself. "What's the problem?" Ingrid asked, her heartbeat now fractionally elevated. A gaggle of last-minute travelers lined up behind her and murmured their impatience. Benita pursed her lips and stood a little straighter.
"It's probably nothing, but I need to call airport security. It won't take long. Please take a seat, madam."
Ingrid was not about to sit down. She stepped to one side for the other passengers to board while Benita radioed for backup.
"What have you done, love?" one of the travelers asked. "You on the FBI's most wanted list or something?"
When the passengers had gone through the doors, the younger woman closed them.
"What are you doing?" Ingrid asked.
Anxiety constricted her throat. Had purchasing a ticket without bureau approval triggered something in a database? Did they know she was planning to walk away from her job and throw her life off a cliff?
"They were the last passengers."
The attendant gripped the door handle.
"I am the last passenger." We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.